आधे उनको आ जाएंगे।
Yeah, one of the major responsibilities which was assigned to the Wildlife Institute of India way back in 1990 was to conduct an environmental impact assessment of the major dams which are coming up on the river Narmada in the state of Madhya Pradesh. The idea of the study was to generate scientific information, baseline information on the kind of environmental losses which are going to accrue as a result of these projects and these dams coming up. And in the event of these dams coming up, how these losses can be minimized. So with this background, this institute conducted a multidisciplinary study, and we used the modern technology of geographical information system, in which we have now tried to show, digitize the rivers. These are the two dams which are coming up, the Narmada Sagar Dam in the state of Madhya Pradesh, and also the Omkareshwar, and then there are a series of dams downstream in the state of Gujarat. Then the idea was, you can see here, that what is the extent of forest loss which is going to occur, what is the extent of agriculture losses which are going to occur, and the third and most important factor was the people who are going to get affected as a result of these dams coming up. So with this background in mind, the institute embarked on a multidisciplinary study. There were a number of scientists, ecologists, managers, student dam height. These are the kind of losses which are going to occur. 403 square kilometers of forest is going to get lost, and about 443 agriculture area is going to get lost. And if we reduce the dam height by just 2 meters, then we see that there is a net decrease in the area of forest and in the area of agriculture which is getting lost. And if we decrease by another 20 meters, this is the kind of losses which are going to occur. So what this technology provides is a trade-off, that what is the optimum height of the dam by which you can have the minimum amount of forest loss, minimum amount of agriculture loss, yet the dam is good enough to maintain its purpose of power generation and irrigation. So this kind of modern GIS technology helps in building out the scenarios before actually the things get implemented in the field. Format into the computerized format. And this process is the process of digitization by which you do that. And you can see here there is a paper map, and using the digitizing table and the mouse, one has to then convert whatever information is there on the paper map onto the computer format.
Is coming there?